got a lot of batteries all the way from this giant guy to this little guy right here. It seems like there's a lot going on.
Yeah, so we're looking at, I mean, a long-term lifespan of batteries and, you know, newer technology, and then like the tried and true lead acid battery that a lot of people might already know about. I mean, this is a deep cycle marine battery, you know, golf cart batteries, that type of deal. Or even your car battery, which we don't recommend necessarily, but that technology.
Okay.
So if you're going to set up an energy independent system that is, you know, either grid tied with a battery backup or off grid entirely, yes, a battery is going to be a very large investment piece in it.
Okay.
Especially for that off-grid component, you are your own power company.
Okay. So probably better to go with something like this versus this in that situation.
Yeah, so what you have, and we'll kind of start maybe older, older to newer. And so a lead acid battery is just that. So you have components in there. This particular battery is not sealed. You do have to fill it with water occasionally. That is the cheapest entry level battery, but you only have 50% discharge rate, which means you can only take it down halfway, and that's considered empty. Okay? Yeah, I know.
It does not seem very effective at all. Kind of like, you know, cheap doesn't always mean good.
Right. But there are great cases for this battery, and that would be in an environment where it's not temperature controlled. Let's say you have it in an outbuilding or an unheated area where maybe it's just a workshop or something like that, or your well house. All right, we do get that that question really frequently. I want to be able to power my well if the grid goes down.
Yeah.
And so for that, we would recommend, you know, your lead acid battery or a sealed lead acid battery. A sealed AGM is something this is called. And so this one is the same technology essentially, except there's no off gassing and you don't have to put any water in it. You don't have all of the temperature issues. It was designed for telecommunications, cell phone towers. And so it doesn't care how cold or hot it gets, not really. If you have the money to do it, the investment is in lithium technology.
Okay,
so if we want to talk about entry level, you know, cost, you're looking at several hundred dollars for a battery like this, several thousand dollars for a battery like this, and 10,000 plus for a battery like that.
Which seems crazy on the surface, but there's a big difference in them. Like one of these at your house is equal to one day of autonomy.
Right, and so, I mean, to get that same battery charging, I mean, I would need 16 plus something of this, and it's in my house. I don't really want to have gassing. You need some kind of exhaust to keep it. It's not something you would keep in your kitchen. Not that I would keep that. Anyway, it's not something I'd keep in my kitchen.
Yeah.
My living room, right? But you, with a lithium battery like the Simplify or the Fortress battery, you can technically drain it down to zero. We don't recommend it. But you can take it all the way down. So the storage capacity on this is a whole lot better. So this can be the equivalent of, you know, multiples of a lead acid battery.
Okay.
And not to mention something like the Simplify, they sell it in 24 or 48 volt, all single by itself. So you don't necessarily have to have multiple batteries wired in series to get to a higher battery voltage.
So more expensive, but easier to maintain, easier to set up.
Right.
Better return on it.
You could get 20 plus years out of a lithium battery.
Wow.
I mean, it keeps its efficiency up, that kind of thing. It requires a little bit more sophisticated charge controller because it is a little bit more sensitive. But a lot of beginners that don't have that budget, that are willing to do a DIY, we'll look into a prismatic cell.
Okay.
And I think you may have talked about this in the past. We started out in our house with prismatic cells, and they are like a 3-volt battery. And so you have to have a lot of them. And then you have to install your own battery management system too.
Okay.
I know this is crazy. So you've got a lot of wires and things like that. This is not necessarily for the novice. I wouldn't necessarily recommend it for somebody right in off the street. But if you know what you're doing and you don't have a lot of budget, but you want to do something with a lithium cell, that is a good starter point.
And one thing I do want to let everybody at home know, it doesn't have to be intimidating, because we've talked before, you can start out with something like this and gradually, as you go, as you get more money and you see your return, eventually move up to something like this or that, or even this big monster right here.
Yeah, absolutely. If you get started with this, you can use this for a few years, you can add on to it, or you can upgrade to something like this and move this off to a different secondary project.
Yeah, there you go. All right, Crystal, well, if anybody has any questions about any of this, how can they reach out to you guys?
They can give us a call. We're open Monday through Friday, 8 to 5. Our phone number is 417-708-5359. Or you can check us out online at windandsolar.com.
All right, perfect. Well, as always, Crystal, thanks so much for having us out today.
Thank you, Mason.